For all of us Martian fanatics, Mars colonization just became closer than ever to being a reality with the start of NASA's CHAPEA mission. On the June 25th, 2023, four volunteers entered a Mars simulating habitat where they would be living for a whole year, testing various experiments and face the challenges of living in a hostile Martian environment. By monitoring their activities and behavior closely, scientists at NASA hope to better understand the challenges of Mars colonization. This simulation will provide valuable data to further advance the Mars habitation efforts by NASA, and of course, other companies like SpaceX won't be standing aside. In fact, it's going to become a stepping stone for Elon Musk's grand idea of colonizing Mars. After all, he is on the mission to reach Mars this very decade. SpaceX itself has also launched a Crew 6 mission that'll play a major role in studying the living circumstances on the Red Planet. But with CHAPEA mission, NASA will bring out a lot of information for SpaceX to use as well. But will this simulation living on Mars be as tough on the crew as it was for the crew of Mars 500? Subscribe to the channel and let's dive into what CHAPEA mission is all about and why it is expected to be highly successful. This is Adventures in Space. CHAPEA stands for Crew Health and Performance Exploration Analog, and in simple words, it's just a simulated living on Mars as realistic as possible. According to NASA, a total of three analog missions are planned, with one analog lasting for around a year, and each mission will have four volunteers enter the habitat and live there using the resources and facilities available to them, just like on the Red Planet. The habitat consists of all the essentials, including a treatment room, separate quarters for each volunteer, a kitchen, a recreation area, a gym, and even bathrooms. The first analog mission for CHAPEA started in June 2023, when four volunteers stepped into the Mars Dune Alpha to begin their solitary adventure. They will live inside the habitat for 378 days, concluding a full year on Mars with adding additional 37 minutes to each day span. More about each crew member is coming a bit later in the video, because first let's have a look at the purpose behind this elaborate experiment. Grace Douglas, the mission's principal investigator at NASA, said that the knowledge we gain here will help enable us to send humans to Mars and bring them home safely. Very general yet precise understanding of the challenges of living in such an environment can affect human beings both physically and psychologically. So with understanding how a human will respond to challenges like dealing with isolation, 22-minute lag in communication with Earth and others, NASA can better plan and prepare for a habitation and exploration mission to Mars. Still, this experiment won't be able to simulate 38% of gravity on Mars or an exact daylight changes. Scientists will still create a hostile Martian environment in as safe, contained place as possible. With making the crew use their EVA suits for limited simulated outdoor walks, scientists will remotely observe the effects of these conditions on the four volunteers for the prolonged time. This experiment will also help scientists monitor how the volunteers utilize the resources they have available. Vital information when making critical resource decisions in future Mars missions. Let's take a closer look at the habitat now, called the Mars Dune Alpha. It is located at Johnson Space Center, a major research base of NASA in Houston. A unique thing about this habitat is that it is made using 3D printing technology. This idea of the quick construction times and reliability of the habitats became the most popular idea of Martian future construction and development. Mars Dune Alpha is 1700 square feet in size, with a hub section and a simulated environment section called the sandbox. The hub section contains four private crew quarters, a treatment room, a robot station, a recreation area, and a kitchen. This is where the colonists will be spending most of their time. So, to prevent monotony for the crew, NASA incorporated various monotony prevention features, such as customizable lighting and sounds, movable furniture, and varying ceiling heights. The sandbox section of the habitat is designed to be a simulation of an outdoor area on Mars. The walls of this section are lined with high-resolution images of the Martian landscape. This way, the sandbox looks like the bottom of a Martian canyon. The reason why an outdoor area is included in the habitat is for the crew to conduct experiments just like astronauts on Mars would do during a full-scale mission. Compared to Mars 500, a previous psychological isolation experiment conducted by Russia, China, and European Space Agency, CHAPEA mission more likely to succeed because of the crew themselves. First analog mission consists of members who are much closer to becoming astronauts compared to the crew of Mars 500. This means they won't be as negatively affected by the long-term close-quarters isolation. The commander of the first analog mission is Callie Haston. With having a doctorate in biomedical sciences, she is responsible for creating models of various diseases during her research. Next is Ross Brockwell. He's a flight engineer for this mission. With a Master's of Science degree in aeronautics, he also has strong knowledge in structural engineering. The third member of the crew is Nathan Jones, who has the role of medical officer for the CHAPEA mission. He has a medical doctorate alongside extensive experience as an emergency medicine doctor, emergency medicine director, and associated professor. Anka Saleri is the science officer for this mission. She is a microbiologist who is serving in the United States Navy. She also has a doctorate in interdisciplinary biomedical science to her name. For obvious reasons, NASA is choosing such highly regarded professionals so we can expect great results. The crew will have to run various experiments and tests during the mission, including conducting simulated spacewalks, communications practices, crop growth, and science experiments for different purposes like curing any disease in space, as well as producing a certain chemical while in there. They will also have to conduct maintenance work as needed to keep the habitat functional. All this will help scientists to monitor teamwork of the crew in the simulated environment. Aside from the experiments and tests, the crew's activities will include meal preparation and consumption, exercise, hygiene activities, personal time, and sleep. NASA intends to have the crew experience planned contingencies to further monitor how they operate as a team in stressful circumstances. For example, an important equipment, such as the garbage disposal system, can no longer be working or certain resources being limited. Unplanned contingency situations could also occur due to equipment malfunctioning in natural way. These situations will test the problem-solving skills of the crew. This way, scientists can see how unexpected problems will affect astronauts living on Mars. Now, why really all of this matter? Mars colonization have been an idea for a very long time. Studies have been done, but there are still what they call the strategic knowledge gaps that NASA is trying to fill in. Scott Smith, co-investigator for CHAPEA, states that at the moment there are four red risks that needed solutions. It includes radiation, spaceflight-associated neuroocular syndrome, a swelling of the eyeball that many astronauts face when subjected to microgravity for a long time, crew behavior, and food and nutrition. Smith says that the most important among these four red risks is the problem with food and nutrition. While previous studies have confirmed that there is water on Mars, that doesn't mean that it'll be enough to support life. Smith says that this new mission will help NASA figure out how they can come up with ideas and solutions to all these problems, especially for the food and water availability. He said that the CHAPEA mission will provide them with the information needed to create food items that can last for a long time. It'll also allow them to study the circumstances that cause the eye condition called SANS. In fact, they will look for treatment with the help of the studies conducted during this whole mission. So it is for certain that not only visionaries like Elon Musk see Mars as a possible habitable planet for humanity, which is why they have emphasized its exploration. SpaceX has already developed the most powerful launch vehicle ever, aka the Starship, yet without the knowledge collected out of CHAPEA mission, it will be hard to envision people's behavior during the journey to Mars, at least. Here you have it, humanity's collective efforts only getting us closer to the moment when first human will step his foot onto the surface of the red planet. And don't hesitate to drop all your thoughts about CHAPEA Mission in the comments down below. Subscribe to the channel to never miss an update on everything aerospace industry related and more. We do 4 essays every week in relevant topics, and if you like this video, you have 2 more in front of you right now. This was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.